Hi guys, I'm Seema and we will be discussing questions related to ratio and proportions. I'll be making more videos on the topics related to quant, reasoning and English for phase 1 of RBI and SEBI. If you like my video, then do subscribe to our channel and for regular updates, hit the bell icon. Today we are going to discuss about ratio and proportions. Ratio is a relationship between any two numbers expressed like this. A is to B is, suppose, 2 is to 3, or we can write this like this in the fraction format. And proportions are written like this: A by B equals to C is to D. As you can see it here, these are two ratios whose underlying ratio is 1 by 2. Only then you can equate it. Question 1. If x plus 16 is to 4x plus 20 is the triplicate ratio of 3 is to 4, then find x. So in this question, it is given it is the triplicate ratio of 3 is to 4. Many students confuse this with thrice of the ratio. No, it's not thrice. What triplicate means is 3 by 4 cube. Triplicate means 3 copies. So if you know this, solving such questions becomes very easy. And on solving this, you get the value of x, which is 11. But you should know what does this means. Moving forward to the next question. A number is divided into 5 parts. This is a long question. And while reading a long question, what we should do is, we should read it very slowly. And simultaneously, we should keep on writing the information that we have. So a number is divided into 5 parts. Don't be scared while you're using so much of variables, because we do not have to find their values individually. Twice the first part is thrice the second part, 4 times the fourth part. Equation 1, twice the second part is 5 times the third part, 6 times the fifth part. Equation 2. Now as we can see, B is the common element in both the equations. So we'll make this coefficient of B equal. So we are going to multiply the equation 1 by 2 and equation 2 by 3. We get 4A is equals to 6B equals to 15C is equals to 8D, 18E. This is our equation third. We have to find the LCM of these coefficients. So their LCM comes out to be 360. We will divide each of them by the LCM so that to make them equal. So here we get A is equals to 90K, B is equals to 60K, C is equals to 24K, D is equals to 45K, and E is equals to 20K. So now we have to verify the options. Option A, the first part is a multiple of 72. We know that A is equals to 90K. And if we put any odd value as K, like K is equals to 1, then it's not a multiple of 72. So option A is incorrect. The second part is divisible by the fourth part. Second part is 60K and fourth part is 45K. It is not true. The first part is a factor of the last part. First part is 90K and last part is 20K. You can clearly see it's wrong as well. The product of the first and the fourth part is divisible by 3. Although it is the only option left, we'll still check it once. Product of the first and fourth part, 90K into 45K divided by 30 gives 135K, which is an integer. Hence, this is right. Question 3. There are 5 vessels with equal capacity, each containing some milk. The quantities of milk in the 5 vessels are in the ratio 4 is to 5 is to 6 is to 7 is to 8. The total quantity of milk in the 5 vessels is equal to the 75% of the total capacity of 5 vessels. How many of the vessels are at least 64% full of milk? Okay, so let us assume that the quantities of milk in each vessel be 4x, 5x, 6x, 7x, 8x. And all these combined are equal to 75% of the whole capacity of container. So we have to add them. 30x is 75%. 40x is equals to 100%. So the total capacity of the container is 40x. So capacity of each container is each vessel. So the capacity of each vessel is 8x. Calculate 5.12x. And as we can see clearly, there are 3 vessels where the quantity of milk is
more than that. So the answer is 3.
Question 4. Number 85 is divided into two parts such that thrice the first part and twice the second part are in the ratio 18:5. Find the first part. According to the question, thrice the first part divided by twice the second part is 18:5. This is the first part, this is the second part. And now, before solving this question, we need to recall something very important. When we multiply an even number with an even number, we get another even number. If we multiply an odd number with an even number, we still get an even number. And if two odd numbers are multiplied, then we get an odd number. Here we see the coefficient of A is 3. So A has to be even because here 18. Just by seeing this observation, and A is the first number, just by seeing this observation, we can eliminate these two options because A cannot be an odd number. And now we can put values in these two and just see. Let's put value in option D, which is if A is 60, B is 25, then 180/50 is 18:5. So D is the answer. In such questions, you should use tricks like these and save your time. Question 5. The percentage of alcohol in two wine tanks is 20% and 40% respectively, and the rest is grape juice. If a wine glass is filled to its half by the tank 1 and tank 2 in the ratio 2:3, and the rest is filled by pure alcohol, then what is the ratio of grape juice to alcohol in the wine glass? As per the question, there are two tanks which contain alcohol and grape juice respectively. So for the tank 1, 20% alcohol, 80% grape juice, 40% alcohol, 60% grape juice. So here the ratio is 1:4, and for tank B, the ratio is 2:3. After this, the question says that a wine glass is taken and filled to its half by tank A and tank B in the ratio 2:3, and the rest is filled by pure alcohol. So A is to B, 2:3, and alcohol. Let us assume that the glass, the capacity of wine glass is 10 liters. So we know that 5 liters is pure alcohol, and the rest 5 liters, we can calculate it. We'll calculate the composition of alcohol. So for tank A, 2 liters into 1/5. For tank B, 3 into 2/5, and plus 5 liters. So plus 5 liters, which gives us 6.6 liters. And grape juice is 3.4. So in the question, it is asked that the ratio of grape juice to alcohol is 3.4, 6.6, or 6.6, which is 17:33. Option D.